Welcome back. We will learn oblique CM anatomy for the left L5 infraneural transforaminal injection and sacroiliac joint injection using ipsilateral oblique, AP, and contralateral oblique CM image guidance. I will start from the left L5 intraneural transforaminal injection. I'll introduce the needle toward the intervertebral disc. The needle penetrates the skin from the lateral to cambium's triangle. The slow and step-by-step movement is faster than rush, so take your time. Then, rotate the CM to AP view. With two different stereo views, I can roughly guess the needle depth and position. I will rotate the CM more. We'll learn the CM anatomy of the contralateral oblique view. This view provides tremendous information about the precise needle depth. Let's focus on the posterior epidural space in the contralateral oblique image. It is outer margin of the vertebral body. It is the outer margin of the intervertebral disc. It is the overlying superior articular process of the sacrum. The needle is passing under the superior articular process and eventually hits the posterior lateral surface of the disc. How much do I need to go to reach the disc surface? The distance relies on the degree of an individual's disc protrusion. If there were severe disc protrusion, the needle already punctured the annulus at this point. If you have MRI, please observe the degree of disc protrusion. Otherwise, I would depend on my sense of fingertips. The contrast media would help confirm the correct space, avoid intravascular uptake, and understand the hydrodynamic of the epidural space. If there is no obstruction of the epidural space, the contrast media would flow to inferior and superior directions. The AP view shows the same pattern of contrast spread. I often use the infraneural steroid injection in discogenic pain, primary or adjuvant to SI nerve root injection. Let's move on to sacroiliac joint. The fastest and best way to have successful SI joint arthrogram is in enough time to spend on the observation period. My primary target is the inferior recess. I try to find the clear marginal line of the sacral side and exclude the overlying bony shadow. The left oblique view provides the optimal image in this patient. It is not always the same CM rotation view for all patients. Some patients need an AP view and others require right oblique view. Let's focus on the inferior aspect of the sacroiliac joint in the oblique image. Sacral border and the yellow line shows the iliac edge. The white circle indicates inferior recess. The targeting the inferior recess is more accessible and higher chance of success rate than any other interosseous joint target point. But there is one flaw. If I miss joint capsule, the needle will overpass and go through to the presacral space. So determination of needle depth is critical in this method. To prevent overpassing, my needle goes to the adjacent bone first, and the tactile sense of bony contact would give me a hint of depth. The second way to confirm the depth is the contralateral oblique image. I had a feeling of popping into the joint capsule, so I turned to CM to contralateral oblique. Is the sacral border in oblique view? We can get 3D imagination from two different angles. I turned the CM to the right contralateral oblique angle because my primary approach was left oblique guidance. The contrast media is filling the SI joint space. There is some leaking of contrast media suggesting multiple synovial capsular tears. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.